Welcome students again into the 11th science chemistry class. We are learning the chapter number 11, adsorption and colloids. Now adsorption phenomena, its different effects and the factors affecting adsorption, we already completed. Again the difference between the chemisorption and physisorption, and also the difference between the adsorption and absorption, we learn all these into the last some lectures. Now from yesterday we are learning the next topic of this chapter, which is nearly half of the portion of this chapter, that is the colloidal solutions or simply colloids. They are also called as the colloidal dispersion. Now we learn the definition of the colloidal dispersion or colloids as they are the heterogeneous mixtures of dispersion medium and dispersed phase. Dispersion medium is always in a large proportion in the colloids and dispersed phase is always in a small proportion. Again, we classify these colloids on the basis of the physical state of dispersion medium and dispersed phase into 8 different classes in the last lecture, such as salts, aerosols, gels, etc. And how the dispersion medium and dispersed phase are different into that, in the different state, we already learned. The main colloid or colloidal dispersion is in that the dispersion medium is liquid and dispersed phase is solid. And we generally called them as the salts. Now again, today we are classifying these colloidal dispersion or simply colloids or colloidal solution into the second type of classification of these colloids on the basis of interaction or affinity between the dispersed phase and dispersion medium molecules. And how on the basis of these affinity or interaction the colloidal dispersions are classified, let us learn. So the second type of classification of the colloidal solutions is the classification of colloids based on interaction or affinity of the phases, two different phases, that is the dispersion phase and dispersion medium, dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Now on the basis of the affinity of the phases, of these two phases of the colloids, a colloidal solution is classified in two main types, and that are lyophilic colloids and lyophobic colloids. Lyophilic colloids and lyophobic colloids. But if water is especially as the dispersion medium, then the terms hydrophilic and hydrophobic are used respectively of that lyophilic and lyophobic. So if water is used as the dispersion medium, the terms hydrophilic and hydrophobic are used in place of lyophilic and lyophobic colloids. Now let us learn what is the meaning of lyophilic and lyophobic. Now first, that is the lyophilic colloids. Now lyo means liquid in Greek, lyo means liquid, and philic means loving. We already learned into the nucleophile or nucleophilic reagent and electrophilic reagent. I told you the meaning of philic. Philic means loving or attracting. So lyophilic means liquid loving colloids. And what is the definition of this? Then these lyophilic colloids, the colloidal solutions or colloids in which the particles of dispersed phase have a great affinity for dispersion medium are called as the lyophilic colloids. So the colloids or colloidal dispersion or colloidal solutions in which the particles of the dispersed phage have a great affinity for the dispersion medium is called as the lyophilic colloids. If the lyophilic salt, that is the lyophilic colloid, is evaporated, then what happens? The dispersion medium separates from that of the dispersed phage. It gets evaporated. So, if the lyophilic salt is evaporated, the dispersed phage separates. But if it is again mixed with the dispersion medium, then the colloidal salt can be formed again. If we evaporate the lyophilic salt or lyophilic colloids, it get evaporates, the dispersed phage separates out, and if again we mix into that dry dispersed phage dispersion medium, then again the salt or colloidal dispersion is formed. Therefore, lyophilic colloids or lyophilic salts are also called as the reversible salts. And that is why colloidal salts are also called as reversible salt. The colloidal salt, that is the lyophilic colloidal salts, are also called as the reversible salt. They are stable. These lyophilic salts are always stable and very difficult to coagulate or to precipitate. That means the dispersion medium and dispersed phage is difficult to separate there. So they are very, very stable salts or stable colloidal dispersions, and there is very difficult process to separate the dispersion medium from dispersed phage. And therefore, the lyophilic salts are very stable and difficult to coagulate or precipitate. Now, the second class of this classification based on the interaction or affinity is the lyophobic colloids. Now, phobic means hating, loving, hating, opposite words, or fearing. So, lyophobic means liquid hating or liquid fearing. So, the colloidal solutions in which the particles of the dispersed phage have no affinity for the dispersion medium are called as the lyophobic colloids. So, the colloidal solution in which the particles of the dispersed phage have no affinity for the dispersion medium is called as the lyophobic salt or lyophobic colloids. Now, phobic means fearing. Hence, the meaning of lyophobic colloids is liquid hating or liquid fearing. Once these lyophobic salts or colloids are coagulated or precipitated, they have no tendency to reverse back, or they have no tendency to revert back again in the form of colloidal state. They do not again go into the colloidal state if they get precipitated or coagulated. So, they are the irreversible colloidal dispersion or irreversible salt, or the lyophobic salts are also called as the irreversible salts or irreversible colloids. For example, generally the hydroxides of aluminium, gold and silver are the lyophobic colloids. So, the common examples are aluminium hydroxide, AlOH thrice, ferrous hydroxide, FeOH thrice, gold hydroxide, etc. These are the lyophobic salts. Now, let us distinguish again these lyophilic and lyophobic salt, because it is always asked into the examination. So, let us distinguish between the lyophilic and
लियोफोबिक कोलाइड्स.
पे अटेंशन टुवर्ड्स द ब्लैक बोर्ड. नाउ वी आर लर्निंग द डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन लियोफिलिक एंड लियोफोबिक कोलाइड्स. नाउ विच आर द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू कोलाइड्स. नाउ फर्स्ट दैट इज द लियोफिलिक कोलाइड्स. लियोफिलिक कोलाइड्स आर फॉर्म्ड इजीली बाय डायरेक्ट मिक्सिंग ऑफ डिस्पर्स फेज एंड डिस्पर्शन मीडियम. इफ वी डायरेक्टली मिक्स देम देयर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ लियोफिलिक कोलाइड्स और सॉल्ट्स. बट लियोफोबिक सॉल्ट्स आर फॉर्म्ड ओनली बाय द स्पेशल मेथड्स. दे रिक्वायर द स्पेशल मेथड्स फॉर देयर प्रिपरेशन फॉर देयर फॉर्मेशन of the lyophobic colloids. Now the second difference, main difference of that is lyophilic colloids are reversible. We already learned the lyophilic colloids. In the lyophilic colloids there is the strong affinity of dispersed phage molecules and dispersion medium, and therefore they are reversible. That means after evaporation the dispersed phage and dispersion medium gets separate, but if we add the dispersion medium again there is the formation of the lyophilic colloids. So they are reversible. But lyophobic colloids are irreversible. That means once they get coagulated after evaporation or once they get precipitated, they cannot be reverted again into the colloidal form. Now that is why the lyophobic colloids are called as the irreversible colloids. The third difference is that the particles of the lyophilic colloids or salts are not easily visible even under the ultra microscope. They cannot be visible. We cannot see the particles of the lyophilic colloids by the ultra microscope or naked eyes also. But the particles of the lyophobic colloids can be detected easily, or they can be visible under the ultra microscope. We can see the particles of the lyophobic colloids under the ultra microscope. The next difference is lyophilic colloids are self-stabilized. That means they always stay in a stabilized form. That means they do not get easily coagulated or precipitated even we kept them for a long time. That means they are self-stabilized. They do not require any stabilizer. But the lyophobic colloids are unstable, so they require always a little or traces of the stabilizers. Lyophobic colloids are unstable and hence they require the traces or little of stabilizers, and then they are stable. The next is that is these lyophilic colloids require addition of large amount of electrolyte for their precipitation or coagulation. If we want to precipitate or coagulate the lyophilic colloids, then we must add into them large amount of electrolytes such as acids or bases etc. To precipitate or coagulate them, because they are self-stabilized. The dispersion medium and dispersed phage are so homogeneous in the lyophilic colloids, that is why they are the stabilized, well or self-stabilized. They form so homogeneous, that is the colloidal solution. So they require large amount of electrolyte for their coagulation or stabilization, precipitation. But the lyophobic colloids are already, they are unstable. They require the stabilizer for their, that is the stability. And therefore, by addition of a small amount of electrolyte, they can be precipitated or coagulated. So addition of small amount of electrolyte causes the precipitation or coagulation of the lyophobic colloids. The next difference is The viscosity of the dispersed phage in lyophilic colloids much higher than that of the dispersion medium. That means the dispersed phage is more viscous than the dispersion medium in case of lyophilic salts or colloids. But in case of lyophobic salts or colloids, the viscosity of the dispersed phage is nearly same as that of the dispersion medium. Both are same viscous, that is the dispersed phage and dispersion medium in case of lyophobic colloids. So lyophobic colloids, the viscosity of the dispersed phage is nearly same as the dispersion medium. And the last difference is about the surface tension. The surface tension, that is the longitudinal or that is the perpendicular force applied on that of the dispersed phage particle, that is the surface tension of dispersed phage is lower than dispersion medium. That means surface tension of the dispersed phage is lower or less in than the dispersion medium in case of lyophilic salts or colloids. But the surface tension of dispersed phage and dispersion medium in case of lyophobic salts or colloids are nearly same. So the surface tension of dispersed phage is nearly same as that of the dispersion medium. Now this is the second classification of the colloidal solutions or colloidal dispersions or colloids, which is based on the interaction or affinity between these two phages of the colloids, that is the dispersed phage and dispersion medium, and they are classified as the lyophilic colloids and lyophobic colloids, and how they are distinguished from each other, all these we learn in this video. So students, if you like this video, then you share, subscribe, and again told the another students of the another 11 science students of the different colleges to like, share, and watch this video. And you always take a screenshot of the blackboard writing, and you must write down all these notes in your notebook. I will check when college will open, and this is very important for your entrance examination also. So you must note down all these that is the blackboard writing in your notes. So all the best for your study. Thank you.